Picture this. It's 1933, you're driving at night, and there are no streetlights. The only thing you can see are the dim reflections of your headlights in the trolley tracks lining the road. Next thing you know, the trolley tracks end, and it's pitch black. In the distance, you see this. What would you do? Would you turn around and book it? Or would you go outside to investigate? Well, a man named Percy Shaw found himself in this exact same situation, and he used it as an inspiration to start a company that would go on to save millions of lives. But what exactly did Percy Shaw see? Actually, it was just the reflections of his headlights in the eyes of a cat. To understand what really happened, we first need to understand how our eyes work. Our eyes have many different parts, but let's focus on the back of the eye, on a layer of tissue called the retina. This is where light is collected from the outside world and converted to chemical and electrical signals that our brains can interpret as images. Our brains actually receive these images upside down and has to do lightning-fast post-processing to flip everything we see right side up. The actual cells responsible for collecting this light are called photoreceptors, and they come in two different types, rods and cones. In certain animals, behind these rods and cones is the tapetum lucidum, a layer of tissue at the back of the retina that reflects visible light back. It's located in retinal pigment epithelial, or RPE cells, and I'm actually using human RPE cells for my research. Sadly, humans don't have a tapetum lucidum, but when present, it gives photoreceptors a second chance to sense light that wasn't detected on the first pass through. The extra light that wasn't absorbed after being reflected is then sent back out into the world. Due to the shape of the eye socket, the light is reflected back in a special way called retroreflection. This means most of the light is being reflected back in the same direction rather than scattering in all directions. This is the reason animals' eyes glow. You're seeing light that's normally absorbed by the retina being reflected directly back at you. Interesting side note, the tapetum lucidum is comprised of chromatophores, or cells that produce color. Certain types of tapetum lucida reflect light using plates of guanine nanocrystals. I did hear that guanine and cytosine broke up, but I'm glad to hear that guanine's doing well for himself. This same class of chromatophores is also the reason chameleons can change their color. They have guanine nanocrystals within a layer of skin cells, and the spacing between these nanocrystals determine the wavelength that is reflected and what color we see. It's also a misconception that chameleons change their color to camouflage. Scientists now think that the chameleon's color dynamics are mostly used to regulate their body temperature and communicate. Back to Percy Shaw. He saw those glowing cat eyes and thought that he could revolutionize road safety. He was inspired by cat eyes and then named his invention cat eyes. Original, right? Percy's feline-inspired creation is a safety device that is used in road markings. It uses the properties of retroreflection to reflect headlights back at the driver, allowing them to orient themselves even in the dark. However, this was not the first commercial use of retroreflectors. Percy Shaw said that he was also inspired by Richard Murray, who patented the use of retroreflectors in road signs 6 years before. Nevertheless, this was the beginning of a revolution in road safety around the world. Retroreflectors are also used to track satellites and have even been to the moon and Mars. It's not just cat eyes. Nature is a great inspiration for a ton of new ideas. Tardigrades, termites, geckos have all inspired inventions with very diverse applications. For example, tardigrades, also known as water bears, can replace the water in their body with sugars to help preserve themselves in temperatures up to 113 degrees Fahrenheit. Scientists are now using this concept to create heat-stable vaccines, which can be distributed to more parts around the world. In a distant part of the animal kingdom, termites are also inspiring inventions too. By studying how termites ventilate their mounds, we've developed air cooling systems that only use 10% of the energy compared to conventional air conditioning. These novel systems have been used in buildings in Zimbabwe as a super efficient way to beat the heat. On top of all this, scientists have also created new adhesives based on the creative way that geckos are able to stick to walls and ceilings. So get out there, look at some cat eyes, or dog feet, or ant hills. You never know what you might see that could be the next big thing in animal-inspired tech.